Hey everyone, Dark Paul here, and welcome back to Game Destroyers TV. So we're back with another episode of Farmer's Almanac, my no money cheat playthrough of Farming Sim. So I've already hired our windrower. Let's go pick it up and get to work quickly because it's gonna cost us money continuously until we get done with it. So yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying this series, and if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. We put out tons of content every day, and if you're watching on an embedded video, same reason, come check us out. So here's our windrower. I got the medium sized one so we could get the fields done quickly and get it back and get it off a hire. Don't want to have it hired for too long. That'd be the same with the baler and then the bale collector. Ugh, horrible view there. There we go. Get her hooked up. And we'll head out this way first and get over to our field over back. And get it taken care of. Fortunately, this tractor's pretty fast. I didn't go too large with the equipment. I was trying to watch my money because we still got 11 grand for the baler and about 4 grand for the bale collector. It's gonna hurt a lot on the cash front to start with, but then we're gonna do some missions to build up our money again, as well as getting our fields replanted. So hopefully we can get back on track. That's my goal anyway, get back on track. Okay, not far to go. Thank God. And get this field windrowed up, and then we'll be good for baling it, and along with the other field as well, get it windrowed up as well. We're not going to get many bales because it's a large square baler, but we'll get enough to start out with. That's for certain. Okay. And then X to unfold. I know I'm kind of in the other farmer's field, but okay, turn on the windrower. Really? You're not doing anything? Of course it's not going to do anything. I forgot to hit lower. Oh my god. What a great start to the episode. Lower windrower. There we go. Now it's doing something. Try and get this all nice and even. Does it come up here? Make for nice, even, neat baling. See, can we? No, I don't think we're going to be able to manage to get three, so. Ah, I'm offline. Okay, there we go. Man, this thing is messing with me. Keyboard steering for the loss. Okay, here we go, coming along nicely now. And I'm just going to drive straight forwards. And then raise the wind roar. There we go. More organized now. Get the stuff around the headland first, and then we can work on the rest of the field. In a more organized fashion. Easy. I'll probably end up messing up these side rows as I start to go back and forward, but it'll all work out in the end. I'm pretty certain of. Now, if I straddle this middle one, will I have enough reach? We shall find out. No, we won't. Unfortunately, we didn't have the big one, otherwise we would have had no problems. With doing that, we'd have been able to get a lot of this stuff all just caught up into one little selection. Eh, not too bad. I get a few bales out of this. There's actually a bit more straw in this field than I thought there was. Which is always good. You see how the mounds are, so once they've been put into the windrows, they're actually quite large. Which is pretty decent. Go, get going again. Yeah, we're making good time along this field. And then the other field's not going to take any time at all. I'm glad this tractor, it's got quite a decent turn radius on it, so I can actually swing round quite tight and get back, you know, get onto each row pretty easily. And nearly done. Couple more swipes and we'll be complete. I'm ready to bail. Well, this field anyway will be ready to bail. The other one needs to be prepped first as well. Or put this machinery off of hire. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get out of control and wiggle around, that's what I'm gonna do. But yeah, I was gonna take a bit of that diagonal line there and just straighten it off from the headland. Makes for easier combining in the future. Not combining, baling. I'll do the same here. I'll basically just run into it and bring it all together. So and one more little piece and we'll be all good. Are pretty much all good on this one. Yeah, I think I'll do this. So we'll head to the other field and get it taken care of now as well. Get it all in one episode. And then next episode we will be baling. All good. All good down on the farm. This cow print's actually quite a powerful tractor. When you're actually driving along in it, it hauls equipment very easily. I forgot, I need to check to see what model it actually is. Valtra. I remember when they came onto the market in the area where I was in the UK, farmers started to grab them, started to buy less John Deere's and started buying Valtra and Valmates. Before then a lot of them were driving John Deere's, and before that was British Leyland. I don't know if any of you remember the British Leyland tractors, but I remember my grandfather having one on the farm. He used to use it all the time for everything. The things you remember. I learned to drive in that tractor. And I learned to count by counting sheep. Funny. Crazy that you remember things like that. How do you count sheep? You count the legs and divide by four. That's an old shepherd's joke, that one. Okay, our turn is just up ahead. As I say, this tractor is making great time along this road. I could have silaged the hay, but I decided I wanted to turn it into bales at least this time. Okay, how do I want to windrow this field? North to south, well, along it I should say. I think along these, this way. All be best. Back her up and you just get lined up here. And then we shall begin. What I'm gonna try and aim to do is just windrow around the edges like so. In a continuous line, and then I'll do the back and forward like I did before. Or a near continuous line anyway. There was plenty of green. I know I lost some there on the right, but it happens. Okay, we'll start the back and forwards here, because I've got the road I can use as a turning area at the moment. Makes things a little easier as we come along. There's about to be a bit of noise as someone's coming into the house. Sorry about this. And round we go. The wind roar back down again, and back along we go. Okay, so back and forwards, back and forwards. Try and get as much down through that line as I can into the row. We're doing good time though, so that's one thing at least. We're making really good time. We're not going to cost ourselves an arm and a leg with rental prices. Still expensive enough to hire this thing. Just the base hire alone is not fun. That is for certain. Now, do I have the reach? I don't think I have the reach to do what I want to do here. Which would try and pull this row here into this row. Let's see. Oh, I might just be able to do it. Bring it all into one line down through here. If I can back up without messing up. Okay, I'm going to be able to get most of it into one row by the looks of it. Yeah. Odd little bit I'm not too worried about. I can always scoop it up with the baler. I wanted to get as much of this in one location as possible. Okay. What's left I can get easy enough. So let's get it back, get it off of hire, and we'll be all good. Find the corner. I believe it costs less if you return the equipment to the yard and take it off a hire rather than just taking it off a hire while it's out in the field. I think you get charged for that. Oh, I want to turn in here. That's right. I forgot that. It's okay, we can get in here. So I'm going to go up round this way rather than try and make the sharp 90 degree turn up in the town. I can come up round here. And basically just draw straight through here. Not dent the equipment, and I'm right here at the equipment hire place. The store. I should say, not the equipment hire place, the store. So, let us back up, park us up so that they can take it away. Oh. It's those wheels on the back. Okay, so let's get into our garage, I think it is. Garage. And across the leased items. Return. Okay, we didn't do too bad. It only took a little bit of money off us. So next episode we will be doing some baling. I'm gonna hire the big baler 1290 because it's a square baler. We'll get our bales made with it and get on. So till next time, everyone, stay safe.